After taking a little bit of a deviated path, going back doing some of the cars that we missed out on before, the Alfa Romeo 33 Stradale and the Acura NSX, we are now back moving along in the A through Z series, and we're going to be driving the AMC Rebel The Machine today. And we're going to be turning this into a rally car, because I've been wanting to turn this into a rally car. These were the first two proper muscle cars. These are the first two muscle cars, for sure, of the series, without question. So, I wanted to take them in two completely different rounds. We obviously did the drag racing with the Javelin, which turned out to be pretty fun, actually. And I've used that car in some online races since then. And as long as it's a circuit with a lot of tarmac, then it's pretty powerful, actually. You just gotta remember to get on the brakes real early. So, we're going to turn this into an all-wheel drive rally car, either A-class or S1 class, I'm not really sure which just yet. And then I was thinking about turning the Nomad into a street car and the Atom into an off-road car, just because I feel like that would be kind of funny. So, I'm thinking about doing that. And then we've got a good number of Aston Martins, which I'm very excited about, particularly the DB5, the V8, and the V8 Vantages, the 77 and 1998 as well. The 177 as well is pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie. And really, just all Aston Martins are pretty awesome. Probably the Vulcan, the one I'm the most concerned about, because it starts out at 959, S2 class. That's stock. I haven't touched that thing, and it terrifies me. So, we're going to be moving things right along. I did, right now going on is the Forzathon with the BMW, so I did just go through and buy every single BMW. Here we are. Boom! Every single one of them. I own every BMW there is to own, so we are good to go on that front. I've got a lot of Audis to buy, but and then also quite a number of Aston Martins to purchase as well, but let's go ahead and hop in my, because I didn't even realize, here we go, gonna hop in my Rebel, and let's see what we're gonna do with this thing. This thing actually only weighs about 3,600 pounds when it's stock. I've already added brakes and some other things, so it may have even been less than 3,600 pounds. 340 horsepower with 427 pound-feet of torque as well is pretty impressive. I have a feeling as soon as I put on the rally tires, this car is going to jump up into a pretty high PI level, so I imagine this is probably going to be an S2 build, but 3,600 pounds is not that bad, so I'm actually going to do the stage 2 weight reduction. Yeah, I think that's going to be plenty. That takes it down to under 3,400 pounds, which is pretty nice. Yeah, 756 PI just with the improved tires. Holy crap, those are huge. I don't think I want one. I don't want front tires that big. I'll go for the 245s. I think that'll be plenty. And then I'll go for the massive rear tires because that actually drops the PI. Nope. I don't like that front wing at all. Back wing's just fine. Sure. I don't know, to be honest. You know what? No, I don't want either of those, just because it's gonna hinder my view. So 762 PI, and haven't done anything to the engine yet. Let's see what we can do with this. I have on the on muscle cars, I've been going for the carburetor, because it improves torque, and usually that's what I'm going for. It adds 10 horsepower, but it adds 12 pound-feet of torque, so I've been going for the carburetor first and foremost, and then I'll probably go for the exhaust for the weight reduction as well. How much does the oil and cooling add? It doesn't add anything, so let's keep that in mind when we start getting close to the top of the A-class. Yes. Yep. This is gonna jump the power right up. Yep, there we go. The sport cams and valves is gonna put it up pretty high. And then, let's see, can we... Yeah, we can do that. And then, can we do this? No, we can't. Can we do this? No, we can't. So that is right on the limit. So, we're gonna keep this A-class? Hold on. 51,000 credits? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me go through the full list just in case I do end up buying it. There we go, there's the full list. And it brings it up to 430 horsepower, probably close to 500 pound-feet of torque, down to 3,500 pounds. Yeah, I think that's going to be pretty fun. It's probably not going to top out very high. I'll probably give it a top speed of like 160, something like that. But I think that will be plenty. Actually, I do want to take a look and I have an idea for a paint job. All right, there we go. I've gone for a bit of a gold flake kind of paint job with it, with black rims, and I think it looks pretty good for a rally car. And again, it is 800 PI, top of A class, and we're going to take this thing on some rally racing. I might have to actually even look for a championship. Woo, this thing is 5 events, but that's all right. We are going to do it. So again, this is a 5-race championship. We're going to do all 5 races in the AMC machine, the Rebel, whatever you want to call it, whatever I want to call it, whatever in general. Seems to have 2 names, as far as I could tell. I'm not hugely familiar with this car. When it comes to AMC, you know, I don't know as much compared to other companies, so it's tough for me to be authoritative about it. But yeah, we're doing an American championship, which means there should be a good mixture of muscle cars. And is that an Acura? Acura is not American, guys. I mean, strictly speaking, it is. What is the car on my right there? What did I just overtake? Was that a Fiesta? Was that a Ford Fiesta? So yeah, it's all American cars. We got a Monte Carlo here, or a Buick Grand National. Who knows which one it is, because they have identical body styles. I can't tell the difference between them. Maybe you can. But this is a very twisty circuit. We've obviously driven this before on the channel several times, so this is not a new circuit or anything. I doubt any of these races will be new. This looks like a second gear corner to me. This thing is pretty heavy. I'm feeling that. I'm feeling the weight of the car. But at the same time, it's got a lot of grip. It's got a lot of grip. Oh, come on. I'm trying to go around the outside of this Camaro. It's actually, it's tough to know how much speed to carry in through here. I'm not making very good use of the handbrake. And clearly I'm not using first gear enough, because that actually went really well. Excuse me, sir. Okay, that's not how I'm trying to take that corner. I'm gonna stay out of the water. Oh yeah, that was a nice corner. That was a very nice corner. Okay, I feel like I'm starting to get the hang of it now. Uh-oh. Nice. Nice. I am liking this. I am liking this. Especially because that's a pretty... I mean, that's about as twisty as it gets. Oh, shit, really? Wow, I really, really fudged up that one. Okay, there we go. That's a little bit better. I lost skill points there, but I genuinely don't give a shit about skill points anymore. I have too many as it is. And I'm only barely gonna win it, actually. That Camaro was coming up on me real quick there. So it seems that he had a straight line speed advantage while I had a bit of a grip advantage. So that's a good way to kick off this championship. I'm not sure how close we are to leveling up, but we might find out if this is a lucky car or not. Ever since I broke level 300, it does take more experience to level me up. So yeah, I'm not going to level up this time. I just like the idea of a rally racing muscle car. There's just something about it. Because obviously you can tear it down, you know, you can really lighten it. You can take all the unnecessary stuff out. You can replace the frame with some lighter weight metal, like aluminum or something like that. If you have enough money, you could obviously, you know, use the body of a muscle car. And essentially it's not a muscle car anymore. Just keep the V8, but lighten the hell out of it. Give it rally suspension. I think it would be awesome. I would love to see that in real life. Maybe it's been done in real life. I should Google it. Who is pushing me out? Fucking Acura? dick. Down to fifth because of him. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. That was weird. That was weird over that jump. I need to either go slower or faster into that jump next time by. Nicely through there. Just a little bit of handbrake, just to avoid understeer, and then just full throttled it. I didn't even countersteer. A little bit of countersteering right there, though. I don't think I need to lift through here. Nope. There we go. I'm not gonna get bullied this time. Okay, I thought that was a third gear corner, but it's more of a second gear corner. There we go. Okay, a little bit of counter steering. Not much though, but again, just full throttle, just flooring it. I think S1 would have been too crazy for this car. This is very easy to drive. This is very easy to drive. I mean, I'm just full throttling it for the most part. I don't have to, you know, I don't have to be throttling or feathering the throttle very much at all. I mean, right there, just full throttle, barely held on. Oh, gosh. There we go. That's actually better. I don't know if it was faster. Oops-a-daisy. I could carry more speed through there. It's the last lap, though, so it doesn't even matter at this point. Absolutely dominated. Absolutely dominated that one. A lot further away, but that one was a slower course. So that Camaro that gave me a little bit more of an issue in the previous race, not so much of an issue in this race, purely because he just couldn't make use of that straight line speed. We will level up here. Could win the Chevy Corvette Z06 Horizon Edition, one of the few Horizon Editions that I actually don't have, and we're just barely gonna miss out on it. Okay, race number 3 out of 5. I'm just trying to motor through these as quickly as I can, and without talking in between the races. I'm trying to only talk during the races, which I am failing at doing right now. But the race is about to start, so it's only like 10 seconds of superfluous footage. Oh man, I really like the gold flake, the way that has come out. It looks brown in certain lights, but in the, like, as you can see at the top there, in the direct sunlight, it looks very gold, which is nice. I'm a fan. I'm a fan of how that came out. I'm not the most artistic person on the face of the planet, as I'm sure a lot of you know already. Oh Jesus, is that the Camaro in first? I assume it is! He is gone, dude! I mean, he is gone! Oh man, barely hung on to that one. Nearly hit that barrier. Catching up a little bit now to the leader, or I was until I started that sentence. He is just gone again. Yep, that is the Camaro in first right now. It's Drift King Pro. 32% into this race. Hopefully there's a bit more corners coming up soon. I need to get second at least. Come on. There we are. Thank you. Thank you. There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. 55% into this race. We got this, I think. As long as there's some more corners coming up. Lovely over the jump. Oh, nope. Gonna rewind that. I feel like that's a big problem on the wheel, is it's easier to take jumps wrong. I don't know, maybe it's just me. I don't know if other people on wheel have experienced similar issues. Oh shit, the last part of this race I think is a big long sprint to the finish. I just blocked that guy off a little bit. Which I probably need to keep doing, otherwise he's gonna beat me. Oh god, here he comes. Oh no. No, no. No, no, no. Oh no! No, no. No, no, no. No, 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 no. Come on! Come on! Yes! Only barely. Only barely. Look at that. Second, third, and fourth were only 1 second. They were all within 1 second of me. So, yeah, clearly this car is lacking in power, lacking in straight line speed. It's not lacking in sexiness, though. Yes, I like that paint. I like that paint very much. Look at that angle on the right-hand side there. It looked almost black. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Round four of the championship, and I can say that this car, it's definitely, it favors handling. To unbeatable? No, I wouldn't say I'm winning easily. Yeah, I'll consider that, though. Thank you, game. This is the fourth race out of five, so I want to start talking a little bit about the car. It's definitely focused on handling, but that's kind of what I wanted from this car. I wanted a muscle car that was a rally car. I didn't want a muscle car just with rally tires and rally suspension, but, you know, it's still got the 1,000 horsepower and stuff. Like, this thing is 400-something horsepower, just under 500, or right around 500 pound-feet of torque. I didn't actually look up to see how much torque it had after all the engine modifications. Oh man, I'm losing grip all over the shop there. I didn't look to see how many pound-feet of torque it was, but I think it's safe to say it was close to... I really messed that up. Safe to say it was close to 500, give or take. Good on the brakes, too. Getting a good run on this guy, but I don't know if I have the straight line speed. It looks like I do on the truck. The top three are really starting to break away, but we got time. Around the outside? Around the outside? And then up the inside? Yes. I even left him room. There we go. I need a better line through this one. That's much better. Oh, the cutback. No, look at the power! These Camaros just have so much power. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Wow, I carried so much more speed than him, but again, just as soon as he gets on that pedal on the right-hand side, he is gone. Wow. Wow. Oh my god, this thing is crazy. Oh my god, stop pushing me! What are you doing? Come on. Come on. I'm leading the championship, I know, but I don't even care about the skill points. Yes. Come on. It's tough to know what to do with the gears, though, sometimes. I'm sure you can tell that I'm having a hard time struggling to decide if I want third or fourth. Look at that thing. Look at that thing. It really is magic through the corners. I don't know if you noticed, but seriously, some of those corners, I carried way more speed than I thought was possible. As I'm starting to get used to this car, I'm definitely noticing the benefits of it. It's so much nicer through the corners in comparison to your average muscle car, certainly in a rally scenario or setting of any kind. I think we're going to level up from this one. Yes, only barely, but yes, we are going to level up from that one. So let's see if we get anything good. Could win the Ranger T6 Rally Raid. I know for a fact that thing can do 200-something miles an hour. We do win the Chevrolet Camaro Supersport, which is good because the Chevy's coming up in the A through Z series. It's probably like 20 or 30 episodes away, maybe even more than that, but it's coming. It's coming. Nice! I just won the Ferrari FF on a wheel spin. Hell yeah. That's like my favorite modern Ferrari, to be honest. I just love that thing. And 60,000 credits. Alright, last race with the Rebel. It has been a lot of fun, and actually it just keeps getting better with every race. That last race, I was feeling very confident with the car, so let's see if we can put in another good showing here for this, what is it? North Desert Trail. That sounds like something that this car should be good at. Well, we got the jump on the Escalade and the Honda. Because it's a Honda, let's just call it what it is. Oh yeah, I took the wrong line for that. The Drivatars up ahead had the right line for that corner. You may have noticed them taking the right line as I was taking the wrong line. Really? Who's pushing me right now? Who is pushing me right now? Can you guys please not push? Okay, down to sixth. Thankfully, I've pretty much won the championship. I just need to score, like, 1 point to win it. So it doesn't even really matter. What are you braking at the apex for? Did you see him brake at the apex? Who brakes at the apex? What kind of line is that? Oh man, look at these corners coming up. Woo! Hi, fellas! And they're gone. Come on, damn it! Damn it, damn it. Not much left. One more corner, I think. Yeah, I got it. I got it. Yeah! Only barely. Only barely, yeah, by 2/10. Just about timed that perfectly, but clearly, if we've learned anything from these videos, it's that the 1969 Chevy Camaro is completely overpowered. But also, the AMC Rebel is pretty badass. It has been a fantastic car, and I really like this paint job, too. Again, I know I've said it, I really like how that has come out. It looks very, very nice. So yeah, I am absolutely 100% satisfied with this car as a rally car. So, if you guys got a Rebel, and probably most of you do, I feel like it's a fairly common car for most people to have, then I would definitely consider tuning it for rally. If you like something a little bit faster, then yeah, absolutely go for S1 class. But for me personally, I like this as an A-class car. I mean, if you really want a little bit more power and a little bit less handling, then all you have to do is just take make the front tires skinnier. Because remember, it was 10 PI for the front tire upgrade that I got. So if you don't go for that, that gives you an extra 10 PI to play with as far as horsepower. You probably get another 20, 30 horsepower out of it that way, something like that. So certainly, you know, you can tweak this, make it your own, that sort of stuff, but I think the overwhelming, and also you could choose to not do the weight reduction as well if you wanted to get some more power in here. Remember, it wasn't even that heavy stock, so if you wanted to leave it the stock weight and just make it 600 horsepower, it would probably still be A-class. Yeah, it's really impressive. I'm very happy with this car. I think, well, it's definitely more fun than the Javelin. It's definitely more fun than the Javelin.
Considering shutting these street races down, you know. Even if you do seem to be doing a pretty good job of embarrassing them.
Oh, I hate you so much, Kira. Anyway, that's going to do it for this episode. I did spend a lot of time actually driving in this one. And I hope you guys got a good idea for just how great this car is, because it really is fantastic. So, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time for the Ariel Atom. Yeah.